molecular basis of inheritance. This lesson is chromosomes basis of inheritance. No, molecular basis of inheritance in NCERT, that is second unit genetics, under that chapter number 6 is molecular basis of inheritance. Okay, right. See, molecular basis of inheritance. During 11th class we studied DNA structure, RNA structure, protein structure. First of all, see what is inheritance, then we'll go for that detail of structure of DNA, RNA and proteins, then we can come to total process of molecular basis. Okay, see here, inheritance. What is inheritance? You may have an idea. Inheritance is transmission of character from one generation to next generation. Many people will say next from one generation to another generation. That is quite wrong. One generation to next generation, or next proceeding generation, or parents to progeny, that is correct one. One generation to another generation means which another? One to another, okay. That another one is where? That is the question. So one generation to next succeeding generation. Suppose one parent is there, from the parents, characters are transmitted from parents to their progeny. Then in next generation, again from that progeny, that will be character to their progeny. So any organism will get exact characters or the DNA which is responsible for the characteristics from the parent. So that the transmission of characters is called as inheritance. If total characters are inherited, that is called as heredity. Under biomolecules, you might study DNA and RNA. They are responsible for inheritance. They are carriers of hereditary information. What is hereditary information? Information regarding the characteristic feature. Suppose one human being has morphology, like hands, nose, head, like that. That body parts are there, the body parts which are present in human, the same body parts will be present in next generation also. Okay, in reproduction we discussed, there is by asexual reproduction there is formation of clones. Like clones, here there is formation of new progeny, but that variations may be there. Okay, here no need to discuss about variation. Simply one organism is giving birth to next progeny which is identical to parent. That is reproduction. So during that reproduction, identical characteristics are carried from parents to progeny. How is it possible? That hereditary information or inheritance. Heredity is by nucleic acids, especially DNA, RNA. DNA and RNA are nucleic acids. They are the carriers for hereditary information. Especially in inheritance, how characters are transmitted means, simply for entire molecular basis of inheritance, there is a central dogma that will explain the inheritance of character. Suppose if you take a DNA is present in the form of genes, you know. That DNA which is present in the form of genes, that is converted, or based on the DNA, no conversion, based on the DNA, there is synthesis of an RNA molecule in all organisms which have DNA as genetic material. That RNA is then used for the synthesis of proteins. Here, the synthesis of RNA from DNA is called transcription. And synthesis of proteins from RNA is called translation. This is expression of genes. How genes are expressing means, the DNA which is present in one organism, that is expressed into protein. First, by transcription, the DNA is expressed into an RNA molecule. That RNA molecule is then used for the synthesis of protein. So these two steps are steps of gene expression. So once proteins are made based on the DNA, then characters will be expressed. Take an example. How characters are being expressed? Suppose take skin color of the human. Skin color. We might see many colors like dark color, bright color, which are what we are calling black, white, like that. How it is responsible? The color of skin is majorly due to melanin pigmentation. Melanin pigmentation is based on a hormone called melanocyte stimulating hormone. You might study in chemical coordination integration in human physiology, zoology. Melanocyte stimulating hormone is responsible for melanin granulation in the skin. When melanin granulation is more, then skin will become dull color or dark color. And when melanin pigmentation is less, then the skin will be bright color or white color. Okay. But how it is responsible means that melanocyte stimulating hormone is a protein. That protein have some genes. When the genes responsible for that melanocyte stimulating hormone are expressed, the gene of MSH will express into MSH protein. That MSH protein, if it is expressed, then it shows dark color of the skin. So gene expression is that one. Not only that, growth hormone is there. If growth hormone is produced, growth hormone genes are there. If growth hormone is produced from growth hormone gene, then growth hormone causes growth. Then growth will be normal. If growth hormone is produced more, then it causes gigantism. Very tall people. If growth hormone is not expressed well, that causes a dwarfism. Short people. Okay? So that is for every character or every protein which is present in living organism, that should be made from a sequence present in DNA. But proteins are made upon binding of amino acids, you know. Chemically, proteins are what? Yeah, I will tell you. Now, there is no reverse translation. There is reverse transcription. I will explain. Wait. Sadhana, wait. So, here, proteins are made with amino acids, you know. Proteins are made up of amino acids. But the binding of amino acids to make that protein, the information is present in DNA. So formation of protein is based on the information which is present in DNA. Okay, that is very important. So based on the nucleotide sequence present in DNA, there is expression of RNA molecule followed by protein molecule. That protein molecule will give protein. That protein molecule will give a character. Suppose there is another process. If DNA is made from DNA, then that process is called replication. Replication is a process where DNA is synthesized from pre-existing DNA. Okay. Now, this is the introduction only. You no need to take any notes for this. No need to take any notes. I am giving just introduction regarding the chapter, then we will go for lesson. Then, if any DNA is made from RNA, then that process is called reverse transcription. Reverse transcription. See, now totally four processes are there. What are they? Replication, transcription, translation, reverse transcription. This is totally called central dogma of molecular biology. Central dogma of molecular biology. Molecular biology means study of molecules or study of inheritance characters at molecular level. What is molecular level? DNA is a macromolecule, molecular level. RNA, protein. So at molecular level, we are studying the inheritance pattern. That's what we are calling molecular biology. This is called as molecular basis of inheritance. What is molecular basis of inheritance? Here simply inheritance of characters is based on the DNA or genes present in DNA. That is, DNA is expressed into proteins by transcription followed by translation. That transcription and translation will give a protein. That protein will express a particular character. This is the total chapter. Total chapter means based on these four concepts only, entire chapter is depending. Based on four concepts: replication, transcription, translation, reverse transcription also. That's why it is called a central dogma of molecular biology. Total chapter. Vikram, close your video. Total chapter is based on this central dogma only. Okay, right. Before going to that, just describe the work of some scientists. Then we'll go for the structure what we studied in 11th standard. Okay. Normally, this inheritance pattern was first studied by Mendel. Mendel, especially G.J. Mendel, Gregor Johann Mendel, he is the scientist who studied the characteristic feature of inheritance. He studied pattern of inheritance. The pattern of inheritance is first studied by Mendel. That studies of Mendel only we are calling Mendel genetics. That is another lesson. There will come in detail. So pattern of inheritance is studied first by Gregor Johann Mendel, and he studied that expression of character is under control of factors. He proposed factors are responsible for expression of a character. That's what we are calling alleles. Now allele, genes and alleles, nowadays we are calling that factors as alleles. Simply he told that there is expression of character which is under control of allele. But this Gregor Johann Mendel work was not clear for about 100 years, because Gregor Johann Mendel did many experiments on garden pea plants and some other plants. He combined statistical data, mathematical data, biological data, like different branches of science, he merged and he formulated results. So better results were not understood well by the scientists who followed the Mendel. So for more than 100 years, this Gregor Johann Mendel work became popular. Later it became popular. Simply, the primitive genetic material was investigated as DNA later. Primitive genetic material was investigated and it was found to be DNA. The primitive or first genetic material investigated is DNA. Later it was also found that RNA also acts as genetic material, but DNA is present in majority of eukaryotic organisms. RNA is present in majority of prokaryotic organisms or DNA. Okay, this nucleic acid was first identified by a scientist called Mischa. Nucleic acid was first isolated by a scientist called Frederick Mischer. Frederick Mischer is a scientist, FRIED. Frederick Mixer is a scientist who isolated DNA or that nucleic acid for first time. DNA was the first isolated by the Frederick Mixer. As he first isolated and as it is present in nucleus, he named that as nuclein. Frederick Mixer first isolated genetic material as DNA. As it was isolated from the nucleus, he called that as nuclein. Okay, then later Altman is a scientist who named it as nucleic acid. The name or the term nucleic acid was given by a scientist called Altman. Altman gave the term due to presence of that acidic property. Why it is called as a nucleic acid? Nucleic acid, it is acidic substance. Acidic substance. It is acidic substances which is present in nucleic acid. So they are called as nucleic acids. Especially DNA was called first nucleic acid. Later RNA was also identified and it was also found to be nucleic acid. DNA and RNA both. Then another scientist called Levin. Levin. L-E-V-E-N-E. Levin is a scientist who found the presence of phosphoric acid. Presence of phosphoric acid and deoxyribose sugar in DNA. He found phosphates and deoxyribose in DNA. The presence of phosphate and deoxyribose was first found by Levin in DNA molecule. Okay, and this scientist he categorized the four types of nucleotides. He categorized four types of nucleotides. What are nucleotides? You know, nitrogen base, pentose sugar and phosphoric acid. If three are joined together, then it is called as nucleotide. Four types of nucleotides: adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymine in DNA. That was the first studied by this one. What is meant by deoxy? One oxygen is left. Left. We will go for the structures of our properties of that DNA. When we go to structure of DNA, there I will explain what is deoxy, what is ribose, everything we will see there. Okay. Then later, Chargaff. Erwin Chargaff is a scientist who found purines and pyrimidines are equal. Erwin Chargaff was a scientist who found that in nucleic acids, purines and pyrimidines are equal, especially in DNA. For double stranded nucleic acid molecule, number of purines is always equal to number of pyrimidines. That's why purine pyrimidine ratio is also called 1:1 or equal. 1:1 means A plus G is equal to C plus T in double stranded DNA molecule. Okay, that is, this is very important. Okay, and other scientist called as Ashbury. Ashbury is a scientist. He found nucleic acid is polynucleotide by using X-ray diffraction studies. He found that DNA or nucleic acids are polynucleotide chain. Polynucleotide chain means many nucleotides are joined together. So that combination of many nucleotides will form polynucleotide chain. That polynucleotide chains are what DNA and RNA we are studying now. Okay. This another scientist, Wilkins and Franklin. Wilkins and Franklin. These are two scientists who studied with that X-ray technique, and they found that DNA helix has a width of 2 nanometer. They found that DNA helix width is 2.0 nanometers or 20 angstroms. 20 angstroms are 2.0 nanometers that was studied. Then each turn of helix has 3.4 nanometers, that also studied. Each helical turn has 3.4 nanometers length. Later, finally, scientists James D. Watson and Sir Francis Crick. James D. Watson and Francis E. Crick. They are scientists who proposed DNA double helix model. They proposed DNA double helix model. This DNA double helix model we are studying for the DNA. DNA is a double stranded polynucleotide chain. That double stranded polynucleotide chain is converted into helical structure. Helical structure is present in the DNA double strand. Okay, they awarded Nobel Prize also. Watson, Crick. Okay. This is about the work of some scientists. Which last point, Siddhi? ASTBURI, Astbury, found nucleic acid is a polynucleotide chain by using X-ray studies. He used X-ray diffraction technique. By using X-ray diffraction studies technique, he found that nucleic acid is a polynucleotide chain. He found that. Okay? Right. Is it complete? Then we go for structure of DNA molecule. Chemical composition of DNA molecule, what we studied in 11th standard, that I will recall once so that it will be very helpful for rest of the chapter. Tell me, is it complete? I think this point may complete. Yes. DNA and gene are same? No. Gene is a segment on DNA. DNA and gene both are not same. Some part of DNA is called as gene. Genes are present on DNA. Okay? Right. Chemical composition of nucleic acid. Chemical composition of nucleic acids. There is a scientist, there was a scientist named Albert Kossel. Albert Kossel was a scientist who found that nucleic acids are, they are made up of 3 units. Nitrogen base, a pentose sugar and a phosphate group. There are 3 units in the DNA or RNA molecule. Nucleic acids are composed of three units: nitrogen base, pentose sugar, and phosphate, phosphoric acid. There are three groups. See one by one. First one, nitrogen base. Nitrogen base. Or the nitrogenous substances which are present in nucleic acids are called as nitrogen bases. These are organic bases present in nucleic acids. These are organic bases present in nucleic acids. There are presence of many nitrogen bases, but in nucleic acids usually 5 nitrogen bases are present. How they did in the X-ray study? First of all, to know about that, we have to an idea on X-ray diffraction. Recall physics X-ray, then you can understand. Okay, right. So organic bases which are present in nucleic acids are nitrogen bases according to that Arbutus Fossil. And these nitrogen bases are two types. These are again divided into two types. One is purine, second one is pyrimidine. One is purine, second one is pyrimidine. The chemical structure we already discussed. Chemical structure of that nitrogen bases we already discussed in 11th standard. With the chemical structure, just I will give briefing regarding that. You can refer that notes. So nitrogen bases are organic compounds, organic bases which are present in nucleic acid. There are two types of nitrogen bases called purines. Purines include adenine, guanine. Adenine and guanine are purine bases. Pyrimidine bases include cytosine, uracil, thymine. Cytosine, uracil, and thymine are pyrimidines. Among them, if you see composition of these nitrogen bases in nucleic acids, adenine, guanine, both are common in DNA and RNA. Both DNA and RNA have adenine, guanine. Cytosine is present in both DNA and RNA. Uracil is present only in RNA, and thymine is present only in DNA. Uracil is absent in DNA, thymine is absent in RNA molecule. Okay. Right. See one by one. First one, take purines. Purines are made up of a heterogeneous nucleus called as a purine ring. Purine ring. What is that purine ring? Purine ring is, just I will give purine ring here. It is enough. Structures of adenine, guanine, you can refer. Class notes of 11. This is purine nucleus. This is purine nucleus. From this purine nucleus, there is a development of two purines called as adenine, guanine. See, how does the purine nucleus? One, two, three, four. Sorry, reverse I am writing. 6 amino purine from here we need to write. That is, this numbering is for pyrimidines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This is the numbering of atoms in heterogeneous nucleus of this purine. This purine has two nuclei, I mean two rings are there now. This one is what? Pyrimidine. Pyrimidine nucleus. This ring is imidazole ring. So, a pyrimidine ring and an imidazole ring are joined to give a purine. An imidazole and a purine nucleus, both are fused. That will give a purine nucleus. This purine nucleus has 9 atoms heterogeneous. This is a nitrogenous base. Here example for this purine, I don't write structure of adenine, just I will give chemical name of that adenine. Adenine is 6-aminopurine. 6-aminopurine means at a sixth position there may be binding of an amino group. If an amino group is present at a sixth position, then it is called as 6-aminopurine or adenine. Second purine is guanine. Guanine chemical name is 2-amino-6-oxopurine. 2-amino-6-oxopurine. 2-amino-6-oxo or 6-keto. 2-amino means here one amino group will bind, then here keto group is binding, means like this there is ring. This is called what? Guanine. Guanine is 2-amino-6-keto-pyrimidine. This is totally a purine nucleus. So from the purine nucleus there is formation of two types of molecules or two types of purines named adenine and guanine. Adenine and guanine are two purines. Then pyrimidines, second one, pyrimidines. Pyrimidines are made with a pyrimidine nucleus, that this one is only pyrimidine nucleus. Single ring. This is pyrimidine nucleus. From this pyrimidine nucleus, there is formation of three types of pyrimidines. What are that? Example, cytosine. Cytosine is a derivative of this pyrimidine nucleus. Cytosine is, first I will give number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Cytosine. Cytosine is 2-oxy-4-aminopyrimidine. 2-keto-4-aminopyrimidine. That means this is first position, I mean second position. To the second position there is binding of a keto group, then it will become NH. 4 amino means fourth position, one amino group will be bound like this. So 2-keto-4-aminopyrimidine is cytosine. Refer class notes of 11th class. Then second one, uracil. Uracil is 2,4-diketopyrimidine. 2,4-dioxopyrimidine is called uracil. 2,4-dioxopyrimidine is uracil. Third one is thymine. Thymine is 2,4-dioxo-5-methylpyrimidine. That is thymine. Okay, one important thing, I don't know the exact rules of IUPAC nomenclature. This one, this is amino, this is keto. If it is important to give alphabetical name of groups in order, then 4-amino will come. I don't know the IUPAC name, that's why I'm saying. I gave this names based on the number of carbon atoms. Here, second carbon first, then sixth carbon. So amino keto. Keto amino, second carbon first, then fourth carbon like that. Right. Okay, I wrote that names like this. If this is correct, that is IUPAC name. Okay, otherwise, here IUPAC names are not enough. You can just mention the names. Is this correct? Anyone tell me? According to IUPAC? Anyone? Where is Suhita? You are saying oxo, but while you writing keto, sir, both are same. Yes, oxo keto both are same. For cytosine, 4 amino, 2 keto. Okay, so A should be written star. That's why I'm saying alphabetical order words should write. Okay. Alphabetical order is important. Then means 4 amino, 2 keto. Keto means oxo. Keto group is same oxo group. Keto oxo group both are same. Okay, here IUPAC names are not important. Just mentioning the name of groups and position of groups, that is enough. Okay, these are two types of urines. Yeah, is it complete? Yeah, completed, sir. Completed, sir. Okay, note down this. If anyone didn't write, complete this, then we go for the next one. Is it complete? Refer class notes of 11th class for all structures of adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymine, uracil. Adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymine structure. They were given in 11th class notes. You can refer that class notes. That's why when I am teaching biomolecules, I told you biomolecules lesson is very important. That based on that biomolecules only, this one is fully depending molecular basis. Based on molecular basis, genetics and remaining biotechnology are based. Okay, done. Then second category, second composition of nucleic acids, pentose sugar. What is a pentose sugar? Pentose sugar we discussed in carbohydrates we might study. Pentose sugar, sugar is nothing but a saccharide or sugar. Pentose means a type of monosaccharide with 5 carbons. So pentose is monosaccharide with 5 carbons is called as pentose sugar. Pentose sugar is a carbohydrate that is belonging to a monosaccharide and that is a 5 carbonyl sugar. It is called as a pentose. In nucleic acids there are two types of pentose. Two pentoses are present in nucleic acids, DNA and RNA. In nucleic acids, DNA and RNA, there are two types of pentoses. One is ribose. Ribose sugar, actually if you write ribose, ribose is an aldo pentose we discussed in 11. What aldo pentose means? It is a monosaccharide with 5 carbons and aldehyde as a functional group. If you see the ring form of pentose. It has a 5-carbon ring form. This is furanose form. Furanose form of pentose. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons are there. First carbon HOH, second carbon HOH, third carbon also same, fourth carbon has a H, and fifth carbon has CH2OH. This is ribose. Ribose. Second one is deoxyribose. Deoxyribose. Deoxy. Someone asked me, sir, what is deoxy? D means less. Oxy means one oxygen. If one oxygen is absent in ribose, then it is called deoxyribose sugar. This is deoxyribose. See, compare that both structures. First carbon HOH, same. Second carbon HOH is there, but here there is no oxygen. One oxygen is left here. Third carbon same HOH, the remaining total it is same. In ribose, there is presence of OH group. But in deoxyribose, there is one oxygen is deficient. So as one oxygen is deficient or absent, this sugar is called deoxyribose. This ribose is present in, it is found in RNA molecule, whereas deoxyribose is present only in DNA molecule. It is present only in RNA, whereas deoxyribose is present only in DNA. This is the composition. So two types of sugars are there in nucleic acid. One is ribose, which is found in RNA molecules, and the second one is deoxyribose, which is found in DNA molecules. Okay, then phosphate group. I will keep this. That structure also will keep. Here third component. This is what? Ribose. Third component, phosphate group, which is formed from phosphoric acid. The chemical formula of phosphoric acid is H3PO4. It has a structure like this. This is phosphoric acid formula. This phosphoric acid is majorly involved in formation of sugar phosphate backbone. The major structure of nucleic acids, whether it be DNA or RNA, that is what sugar phosphate backbone. That sugar phosphate backbone is formed by the phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid is very important component that is responsible for formation of sugar phosphate backbone in DNA and RNA. In both DNA and RNA, there is formation of sugar phosphate backbone with the help of the phosphoric acid. Ribose, one oxygen. Deoxyribose? Hey, what wrong? Madam. Yes, tell me, madam. Simana? Yes, yes, minus one oxygen. Ribose minus one oxygen is equal to deoxyribose. Yes, yes. Right? These are three components. So what are three components of nucleic acid? Nitrogen base, pentose sugar and phosphoric acid. These nitrogen base, pentose sugar and phosphoric acid totally unite together and form a structure called nucleoside. Which one forms sugar? Hey, sugars are direct carbohydrates only, run. Yeah, this is CH2OH, this is OH, H. This is oxygen. Oxygen. The formation of this oxygen bond also I explained in 11th biomolecule. How that oxygen is formed. The formation of this oxygen, this linkage is also I explained in biomolecules 11. That you can refer one. Okay, is it complete? Okay, I want to rejoin in the meeting due to personal issues, sir. Okay, Lingesha. Lingesha, you can join. Did I? Wait. 5 minutes, I'll complete that. So, now, that nitrogen-based pentose sugar phosphoric acid has that, that combination will form two units called nucleoside and nucleotide. What is a nucleoside means? If a nitrogen base joined with pentose sugar, that will form a nucleoside. Nucleoside. See here, just I am giving an example. Suppose I am writing a pentose sugar here. OH, H, H, OH, H, OH, H, CH2OH. This is a pentose sugar. Which sugar it is? It is ribose. This ribose combines with the nitrogen base. Take a nitrogen base. Suppose, find this nitrogen base what I wrote here. Here NH2. Tell me, what is this nitrogen base? What is this nitrogen base? Adenine, yes. This adenine, 6-aminopurine, which is adenine. This adenine combines with this ribose by forming a glycosidic linkage. This glycosidic linkage is forming is N-glycosidic linkage. By forming one N-glycosidic linkage, a nitrogen base combines with pentose sugar and forms a nucleoside. Here, how that binding is forming N-glycosidic linkage. That N glycosidic linkage, see here, this is the first carbon, this is the ninth member. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So in purines combine, purine ribose is there, na? That is 1, 9 N glycosidic linkage is formed. 1, 9 N glycosidic linkage means first member of pentose combines with ninth member of nitrogen base. That is 1, 9 N glycosidic linkage. In pyrimidines, right? sorry, purine pentose. Yes, yes. Purine pentose joined by pyrimidine pentose joined by 1-1 N glycosidic linkage. 1-1 N glycosidic linkage. First carbon of this pentose, either ribose or deoxyribose, that will combine with the first member of pyrimidine. Pyrimidines have first member nitrogen. Just now I gave you structure of pyrimidine ring. That will form N glycosidic linkage. So a nitrogen base, if it is bound to a pentose sugar, then it is called as nucleoside. Then another structure is formed, which is called as a nucleotide. Nucleotide is a nitrogen base plus pentose sugar plus phosphoric acid. If all three are bound, then it is called nucleotide. Then it is called nucleotide. A nitrogen base, a pentose sugar, and phosphoric acid. If all three are joined together, three members are joined together, then it is called as what? Nucleotide. How that nucleotide is formed? Just that structure simply I am writing here. Suppose this is a pentose sugar. Adenine structure I didn't write there. Simply I mentioned adenine. CH2OH. This is one nucleoside. To that, see here, nitrogen base plus sugar is a nucleoside. To that nucleoside, nitrogen base plus sugar is nucleoside. To this, if a phosphoric acid is bound, this is called nucleotide. So how nucleotide is joining means phosphate joins or attached, binds at fifth carbon of pentose in nucleoside. Otherwise, fifth carbon of pentose. To the fifth carbon of pentose, there is attachment of a phosphate group. If a phosphate group, nitrogen base and pentose sugar three are joined, then it is called as a nucleotide. This nucleotides are the basic structures of nucleic acid. That nucleic acids are called polynucleotide chains, na, whether DNA and RNA. DNA is a polynucleotide, RNA is also polynucleotide. Okay? Right, complete this. Then just 2 minutes I will give list of the nucleosides and nucleotides, then you can take break. Yes, it is adenosine monophosphate. Adenine, that names of nucleosides I will give. If you write that names of nucleosides like a tabular column, then you can understand well. Tell me if it is complete. Sadhana Sri, MA, day after tomorrow. How many marks will get Sadhana Sri MA? Tell me your target. Is 120 by 120 possible? Can I expect 120 out of 120? No idea. Not SC, 5 prime C, 5 prime carbon. Sadhana Sri, 120 by 120. உலகே சரண் டார்கெட் ஹை. ஐ ஃபர்கட் தட் ஸ்ரீஹர்னி, வேர் இஸ் ஸ்ரீஹர்னி? நாட் கெட்டிங் மச் மார்க்ஸ் இன் 11th கிளாஸ் எவ்ரி டைம் பாட்னி டாப்பர் இஸ் ஸ்ரீஹர்னி மெஜாரிட்டி ஆஃப் டைம்ஸ். ஆல்மோஸ்ட் 50% ஆஃப் டோட்டல் எக்ஸாம்ஸ் இன் பாட்னி ஸ்ரீஹர்னி பிகேம் டாப். Nowadays there is no Sriharani in list. Sriharani name is not in list. Is Sriharani there? Sriharani is on, he is not in class, I think. Sriharani friend. மதுவந்தி, நீலா, வேர் இஸ் ஸ்ரீஹர்னி? வை இஸ் ஹி அப்சென்ட் டுடே? தீஸ் ஆர் டிஃபரண்ட் காம்பினேஷன்ஸ் ஆஃப் நியூக்ளியோடைட்ஸ். Nitrogen base, pentose sugar, nucleoside. They will combine to give nucleoside. If one more phosphoric acid is added, then it is forming nucleotide. Adenosine, guanosine, cytosine. They are forming both ribonucleotides and deoxyribonucleotides. So because these three present in both DNA and RNA. Uracil is forming only ribonucleotide as it is found in only RNA. Thymine is forming only deoxyribonucleotide as it is found only in DNA. Okay, so we can say ribonucleotide for 4 AMP, GMP, CMP, UMP. Deoxyribonucleotides include deoxy-AMP, deoxy-GMP, deoxy-CMP and deoxy-UMP. Purine nucleoside to purine pyrimidine nucleotides also we can differ. So these are purines. Purine nucleosides, adenine sulfate monophosphate, AMP, deoxy-AMP, GMP, deoxy-GMP. Purine nucleotides. Pyrimidine nucleotide means these four are pyrimidine nucleotides. This is combination. Then next class we will go for detailed structure of DNA. Then we can continue this chapter. Okay.